Hey everyone, May the 4th be with you. We are actually at Epcot today because May the 1st, which was the 35th anniversary of Disney's Hollywood Studios, I spent that day over at Hollywood Studios. So today, we are gonna be at Epcot. I don't even think we're gonna mess around with anything over at Hollywood Studios. Skip jump. So we are in line for the annual pass holder magnets, and then we're gonna check out some of the flower and garden stuff. We're gonna check out the annual pass holder lounge back at the Morocco Pavilion, and a whole lot more. I think we might even meet a lot of characters today. So it should be a fun day. So we stopped into the annual pass holder lounge here in the Morocco Pavilion. It's in the restaurant that used to be Restaurant Marrakesh at the back of the Morocco Pavilion. We had to put in a 40-minute virtual queue Then when we got called, we had to wait in a pretty long line again. And then when you walk in, there's the meet and greet with Jeannie. That was probably about a 10-minute wait. And then we had to wait around for a table to become available. So maybe not quite as nice of an experience as I was expecting, but we did get to meet Jeannie, and that's a very special character. I haven't met Jeannie, I think, since 2018 when we were on vacation from Arizona. Right now, I am getting ready to enjoy some of the treats that they have here. And I will say, they have free treats here. So, I mean, that's something, right? You don't get free very often at Disney, but it is a long wait. Got some Planters, a Peanuts mix here, and a Chex mix. And I just poured some honey into this Moroccan mint tea. So I didn't really have something to stir it. So there'll just be clumps of honey down at the bottom, I guess, but we'll give it a try. Yeah, I'm gonna need to find a stirrer or something. Oh, thank you. Somebody gave me a stirrer, I mean, a straw anyway. So that should help. Let's see if I mix this up a little better. Yeah, I mean, that is better with the honey, but maybe just not my jam. That's okay though. Got some snacks. We're gonna sit here for maybe a couple minutes, and then I think we're next heading to the Germany Pavilion, and we might try to ride Frozen, and we're just gonna keep enjoying Epcot. We have made our way over to the Germany Pavilion from the stand Summerfest. My wife Courtney is a member of a Facebook group called Disney Food Fanatics, and they actually gifted this one to her. It is a pretzel pudding cake, correct?
Pretzel bread pudding.
Pretzel bread pudding. And it is pretzel with vanilla and caramel. So I am going to dig into this. Here we go. Wow. Really, really good. It reminds me of, well, almost like a cinnamon roll, only if the cinnamon roll had a more substantial base. So yeah, it is really good. It's at Summerfest here at the Germany Pavilion. So we were gifted another food item from Disney Food Fanatics. Thank you so much. That was really, really nice, and we're really enjoying it. Please, everybody, if you have a Facebook, go to Disney Food Fanatics. This is from the caramel store in the Germany Pavilion. It's the carrot cake. So oh my lord, is that good.
I didn't see this on the menu, so I think it is a special item and may not always be year-round.
So I hope you heard Courtney say that this might be a special item for this time of year.
Are you saying the menu?
Actually, I'm a little surprised that it's not in the fall, because this really kind of screams fall. I guess the carrot because of Easter and everything, but it just really has those fall vibes to it.
Adding on.
I can't, you know.
Carrot cake whoopie pie. So, wow. Really, really good. There's caramel on top of the actual cream in the center, and then it's carrot cake as the outer shell. So good. So good. This was better than the other item, I would say. And that's saying a lot, because I love pretzels, and that was an understated, not too sweet dessert. But this one is fantastic. As you can tell, I'm jumping in here later in the night. After we spent the day at Epcot, Courtney and I actually had a dining reservation at Artist Point at Disney's Wilderness Lodge. So in a couple days, maybe a couple weeks, look forward to seeing a dining review from Artist Point at Wilderness Lodge. However, while we were at dinner, in addition to watching Shohei Ohtani hit his 8th home run of the year on my phone, Courtney told me a story that happened during the day at Epcot, and I wanted to sort of break in here to share that story. So you just saw us meeting Mulan. Well, Courtney got some pictures taken with Mulan, and I was not in those pictures. I was, you know, shuffling around with our stuff. And I've mentioned before, Courtney has mentioned on the show as well, that she deals with chronic illness. And when she met Mulan, she said, "Boy, I would like to be a warrior like you, but I'm, you know, dealing with chronic illness, so I guess I'll have to be a chronic illness warrior." And Courtney went on to tell me what Mulan said to her in that situation, and it was incredible. It was empathetic. It was sympathetic. It was really amazing. She said, "You know, I don't want to brush right past that because that's a big deal, and, you know, it might be harder to advocate for yourself and to, you know, continue going to the doctor's appointments and doing everything for your own health. It might be harder doing that than, you know, being a warrior for China." And that interaction, I didn't even know that was happening while I was just, you know, shuffling around with the bags, putting our drinks down and getting ready to, you know, get the photo pass pictures that we always get. And it's those kind of interactions that I don't want to forget. We talk about this podcast, this YouTube channel, and we talk about wanting to be inclusive. We want everybody to feel welcome, whether you're chronically ill, you're disabled, maybe you're autistic, a person of color, women, domestic violence survivors, members of the LGBTQ plus community. We want everybody to feel welcome, and at their best, the Disney theme parks make people feel welcome. And that's what Mulan did today for my wife, and it's those kind of interactions that I'm never going to forget and are going to be the reasons that I continue to go to Disney. So I just wanted to break into this Epcot vlog to mention that. And now, after meeting Mulan, we checked out Reflections of China, the 360 show.
Shanghai, a city forever reinventing itself. Vibrant, sophisticated, romantic. Oh, my God.
saved her sister with an unselfish act of true love before a frozen heart.
My wife Courtney wanted to meet characters today, and I think we did a pretty good job of that. We met Jasmine, we met Genie, we met Mulan, we met Anna and Elsa, and now we are taking a break to have some food. I grabbed the seared scallops for her from the Canada booth here for the Flower and Garden Festival. She said the scallops were seared very well. There was like a vinegar flavor and some bacon. If the wind is blowing and hitting the mic, I apologize for that. I'm doing the best I can as far as that's concerned. But she really liked the balance of flavors with the seared scallops. For the third or fourth time in this festival, I am getting the buffalo chicken plant-based poutine, which is basically just the buffalo chicken strips that they had for Festival of the Arts, but they are on tater tots. It's really good. I've had it, like I said, this is like my third or fourth time getting it. This festival just shows you how much I like it, but let's try it again. It's pretty spicy. Yeah, very, very good. A little bit of a kick. And it's at the refreshment port, or the refreshment outpost or whatever. Refreshment port, I guess. And just so you know, they do not have Coke Zero there. So I have to have this with no drink. So I'll suffer through it though.
Our journey begins as dramatic and sudden changes are sweeping over the land. An approaching storm may seem violent and destructive to us, but to nature, it's a new beginning in the cycle of life. One of those living systems is the rainforest, home to the most amazing concentration of life on our planet. These dense and beautiful forests cover only a tiny portion of the Earth's surface. But they contain more than half of its plant and animal species. Rainforests are also extremely rich in adaptive living systems, providing us with oxygen, food, medicine, and other elements essential to our lives. In the desert, nature has created a very different, but no less beautiful, living system. And while this arid landscape may seem lifeless, it is very much alive. The plants and animals that have learned to survive in these harsh conditions make use of what little water they can find and avoid the scorching rays of the relentless sun. The American prairie once appeared as desolate as the desert, but over time, rainwater and nutrients gradually penetrated the hard surface of this land. Even the hooves of the mighty buffalo helped create the rich soil that would one day become home to the American farm. Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests now and into the future. The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. While there are more than 50,000 edible plant species in the world, most of us are only familiar with the handful that make up our everyday diet. The common grains growing here, wheat, maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world.
Do it for our day at Epcot. Got to really meet a lot of characters. Asha from Wish, Genie, Jasmine. We saw Snow White, met Mulan, met Anna and Elsa. Just a pretty great day. Also rode Frozen Ever After and of course Living with the Land, because we always ride Living with the Land. Tried some good food. The monorail is going overhead. And there's a pretty nice breeze. So a pretty good day, pretty good way to end a good day at Epcot. Like, comment, subscribe. I'll talk to you soon.